I'm at a stop sign, a fork in the road. Shaking my emotions, looking at my options. Which way to go? It's a moment of decision, an opportunity to do what's right by you and what's best for me.
So maybe I will do just what I know that I should do, even when it isn't really what I'm wanting to. I know there is a way that I can honor you, and so I'm gonna do just what I know that I should do.
A good decision. Yeah, I'm gonna stop, I'm gonna look, and I'm gonna listen, yeah, and make a good decision.
I will do just what I know that I should do, even when it isn't really what I'm wanting to. I know there is a way that I can honor you.
I'm Jacob. You ever think about what life was like before the remote control was invented? Just imagine, every time you wanted to change the channel, you had to actually get up, walk over to the TV, and change the channel dial.
We'll be right back after these messages. Don't touch that dial.
I should appreciate you more. But we're not here to talk about remote controls. We're here to talk about self-control. Self-control is choosing to do what you should even when you don't want to. Hey, wouldn't it be cool if we had a remote control for ourselves? An actual self-control? That way, if I was ever feeling bored or something, I could just, you know, change the channel. Like, all right, you varmint, you've met your match. I'm the fastest channel switcher on this side of the Colorado.
Sure is lonely out in space.
Fall back. Pick his target. Pass!
Sorry, Miss Ackerman. Dance party!
I'm the Turquoise Avenger.
I knight thee!
Can't stop dancing! Things are getting out of hand!
Scalpel! Whoa!
Finally, I had to take the batteries out.
That was trouble.
In today's story, we'll find out that when you lose control, trouble is exactly what you'll get. We'll be right back. Don't touch that dial.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Proverbs, chapter 25, verse 28.
Theo Brickman knew he had the perfect name. He had been building brick creations ever since he could wrap his chubby baby hand around a mega brick.
Brick!
As Theo grew older, he moved on to brick building kits, but soon his imagination raced ahead of any building kit or building instruction set you could ever buy.
I want to build Jupiter, all of Narnia, a ginormous flying pizza.
Theo even got a job at a brick building store so he could spend his days surrounded by bricks. So he was overjoyed when he found out that a brick building TV show called Brick Bosses was gonna be holding auditions in his town.
I'll get on the show for sure.
On the day of auditions, several dozen other people showed up along with Theo. He jostled up to the front for a good spot.
I bet not one of them can beat me.
A tiny lady with iron gray hair eyed him sharply as she addressed the competitors.
I am Althea Legoimi, and I shall be judging you on originality, technical skills, and overall conduct. There is a break room if you need a snack or rest, but no food may be eaten here in the brick room. You have 4 hours to build anything you can imagine. Begin!
Theo raced to the side of the room where racks and bins holding every kind of brick stood.
Hey, you stepped on my foot.
You snooze, you lose.
Theo shoveled bricks into his bin.
I'll build a castle, one with turrets and towers and a wonderful moat filled with shiny brick water.
Theo got right to work. Soon, the walls of his fortress began to rise. He designed decorative windows and lofty balconies.
Ooh, I should build a dragon to attack my castle.
As Theo snapped red and gold bricks together to form his dragon, another competitor looked over.
Is that supposed to be a horse?
Can't you see I'm not done with it yet, you blockhead?
As time ticked on, Theo realized he was hungry, so he decided to take a quick snack break.
Just 1 minute.
But in the break room, he discovered his favorite treat of all time.
Dill pickle and pizza potato chips.
Theo downed one whole bag. He desperately wanted another, but the clock was running down.
I'll just sneak this back into the brick room with me.
Theo finished his dragon between stuffing pizza chips in his mouth. He tried to hide the bag, but when he looked up, he noticed Althea spotting a trail of chip crumbs that he left behind.
She probably doesn't know that was me.
With just a half hour to go, Theo's castle and dragon were nearly complete.
I need a wall around the moat. Yeah, with a really cool pattern.
So, Theo began snapping together an elaborate wall. But the wall simply would not behave.
Gotta treat this piece apart.
Pry as he might, Theo could not separate two small plates. Frustrated, Theo hurled the locked pieces across the room. They narrowly missed the head of Althea Legoime, who was examining another competitor's project. She turned her head sharply to look in his direction.
I don't think she saw it was me.
As the final minutes ticked away, Theo fumbled to finish his wall.
Time is up. Wheel your creations up to the judging stand.
Theo glanced around as he wheeled his work table up to the front.
Mine's the best!
But as Theo slid his table into position, it bumped over a crack in the floor. A big section of his perfect wall tilted and then crashed down. No! It was too late. Time was up, so Theo was not allowed to repair the wall.
No fair.
Theo sulked all the way through judging. When the names of the winners were announced, Theo's was not among them.
What a waste of time.
Theo stormed up to Althea.
So, it was my castle wall, right? If that hadn't fallen, I would have won?
It wasn't the castle wall, actually. It was your wall.
What?
Part of your score was conduct. How you acted and followed the guidelines and treated others throughout the audition.
But I built the best creation.
You do an excellent job of building without instructions, but it's pretty hard to go through life without instructions. My favorite guide for life is the Book of Proverbs.
You mean in the Bible?
Exactly. Proverbs 25:28 says, "A person without self-control is like a city whose walls are broken through."
Oh.
If your own wall was in good shape, I think you would have won today and caused a lot less trouble for yourself and the people around you.
But that's not... What if I do? Work on my self-control wall, I mean.
Then you should definitely audition again next season. I think you'll have an excellent chance.
Thank you. I think.
Theo was deeply disappointed not to be chosen for this show, but as he was waiting for the bus to take him home, he downloaded a Bible app and tapped his way to Proverbs. Yep, maybe it was time for some life-building instructions.
One of the wisest people ever, King Solomon, wrote this: "A person without self-control is like a city whose walls are broken through." People used to live in cities with walls around them to protect themselves from their enemies. So, if there was ever a hole in the wall, it meant trouble. You may not have ever lived in a city with a wall, but you can imagine what it would be like if there was a hole in the wall of your home. Ma, there's rain coming through the hole again. And there's a tiger. Walls are there to protect us from harm. When we lose control, it's like those walls are broken through. And that can mean trouble. When you're not controlling yourself,
can't stop dancing!
You're not paying attention to the things or people around you. And that's when things get broken. And when you or other people get hurt.
Oh, fall back. Picks his target. Pass!
Sorry, Miss Ackerman.
Oops.
So, here's the one thing to remember today. When you lose control, it can cause trouble. But I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. If you really wanna control yourself, you're gonna need some help. Here's the good news. Self-control is a fruit of the Spirit. That means when you put your trust in Jesus, and follow him, the Holy Spirit will be there to help you keep control. Because control is something everyone needs. It's okay. It's fixed now. Oops. Well, I reckon it ain't then. Time to ride off into the sunset. Partner. Come on, Bessie, let's go! Yeah!